Hello everyone, I'm Shubham from Intellipaat. In today's video, we're going to discuss about AZ-203 certification. So, without wasting more time, let's get started. First, we're going to discuss how AZ-203 came into existence. If this change came into the picture, there must be a reason for it. After that, why you should opt for AZ-203 certification, the prerequisites required for AZ-203 certification, then most importantly, we will also discuss about the exam objectives, its pattern, and in the end, how you should prepare for AZ-203 exam. So let's move forward. How AZ-203 came to existence? So guys, before 203 certification exam was introduced, AZ-200 and 201 were in the picture in order to get certified as an Azure Associate Developer. But both of these exams got retired and AZ-203 took their place. That is how it came into existence. Everything happens for a reason, and there must be a reason behind this change, right? That we shall discuss as we move forward. Reason for this change. So guys, in the early stages of Microsoft Certified Azure Developer Associate certification, Microsoft Learning received a lot of negative feedbacks about the beta exam being very difficult for people to crack, which are AZ-200 and AZ-201. Based on the feedbacks, they decided to combine the AZ-200 and AZ-201 certification exams into a single AZ-203 exam, that is the Developing Solutions for Microsoft Azure certification exam. So guys, the combined AZ-203 exam is not merely a merging of the full AZ-200 and AZ-201 certification exam. So this AZ-203 exam pulls in approximately 70% of its objectives from the AZ-200 exam and approximately 30% of its objectives from the AZ-201 exam. As a result of the transition, the AZ-200 and 201 certification exams are now retired and are no longer be able to schedule or be taken. Additionally, the transition exam AZ-202 is also retired as a single AZ-203 exam is a singular path to earning the Microsoft Certified Azure Developer Associate certification. And guys, for those of you who are early achievers out there, this may be a bit frustrating for you, I know that. But this change will simplify the certification process to attain it and is a good change to be made. Next, why you should opt for AZ-203 certification. So guys, today Microsoft Azure Developer is ruled out to be one of the most esteemed job titles in the cloud industry. How? Since Azure is one of the pioneers in providing cloud services and it has got majority of its shares in cloud market worldwide after AWS, which means greater job opportunities and no doubt it is being majorly used by majority of the Fortune 500 companies. According to the latest report, the average pay of an Azure developer is more than $120,000 per annum. And it isn't a secret that an experienced Microsoft Azure developer can earn up to $200,000 per annum. So, I guess this should be enough to satisfy a candidate who is willing to go for AZ-203 exam preparation. Moving forward, in order to be well prepared for AZ-203 exam, you must know that what are the prerequisites for the exam, right? So, you need to have at least 1 year of experience in development of scalable solutions that span through the entire software development lifecycle, including software design, development, deployment, testing, and maintenance. You should have a prior experience and knowledge with the Azure platform. Also, you must have a past experience in developing applications using the programming languages such as C#, Python, etc. Now let's move forward and discuss about the exam objectives. Due to the constant feedbacks about the exam being difficult, Microsoft has divided the entire exam syllabus in 6 modules in order to ease the exam preparation. Let us discuss each of these modules below. Developing Azure Infrastructure as a Service Compute Solutions. So guys, this percentage figure that you see here, that is 10 to 15% here, basically indicates the relative weightage of the questions from each of the modules. If the percentage is higher, then you should expect more questions from that module and vice versa. So in this module, you need to be thoroughly prepared with creating containerized solutions, implementing batch jobs by using Azure Batch Services, and implementing solutions that use virtual machines. Second, develop Azure Platform as a Service Compute Solutions, where it holds a weightage of 20 to 25% in exams covering topics like creating Azure App Service, Web Apps, and API Apps. So also, it covers the topics such as Azure App Services, Mobile Apps, and implementing Azure Functions. Third, developing Azure Storage, holding a weightage of 15 to 20%, covering the topics like developing solutions that use blob storage, relational database, Cosmos database storage, and storage tables. Fourth one is implementing Azure Security, holding a weightage of 15 to 20% and covering topics in implementing access control, authentication, and secure data solutions. Fifth one is monitoring, troubleshooting, and optimizing Azure solutions, holding a weightage of 15 to 20% in exam. instrumenting solutions to support monitoring and logging, integrating caching and content delivery with solutions, and developing code to support scalability of apps and services are being covered in this module. And the last one is connect to and expand Azure services and third-party services, which holds a weightage of 20 to 25% in exam and covering topics and establishing API gateways, integrating Azure search within solutions, and developing an app service logic app. Now let's move forward and discuss about the exam pattern. No doubt, the AZ-203 exam is one of the most challenging exams in the IT industry. Although, the number of questions in this exam are subject to change over time. You can expect around 40 to 60 questions in this exam, and also you can expect different question formats and tie-ups in this exam, including review screen, mock review, multiple choices, short answer, hot area, repeated answer choices, drag and drop, case studies, the best answer, and active screen. All the questions in this exam can follow any of these question types. You will get around 150 minutes to complete the examination with an additional 30 minutes of sitting time. For good results in the exam, it is required to follow the weightage associated with the exam module during your AZ-203 exam preparation. The pricing depends on which location you are taking your exam from. For an example, if you're taking your exam in USA, then it is going to cost you around $165. But if you're taking it in India, then you will have to pay an amount of 4800 Indian rupees, and the pricing is subject to change without a notice from country to country. As the pricing does not include applicable taxes, you need to confirm with your examination provider for an exact fee. If you're a student, then you can get a fee reduction in the exam if you can submit your valid educational credentials. Microsoft trainers and academy program members are also eligible for reduced pricing. Most of the Microsoft technical questions require a passing score of 700. AZ-203 is not an exception here. Any score greater or equal to 700 will be marked as passed. Otherwise, it will be marked as failed. So most of the short questions in this exam are 1 point. If any question is worth more than that, then it will be indicated in the exam part itself. Also, note that there are no penalty for an incorrect answer. The exam is available only in English language. As we know of the examination pattern, now let's discuss few of the tips for the preparation of the exam. How to prepare for AZ-203 exam. So guys, the first step is to plan the module structure and study accordingly. For an example, if you're going to start with the app services and containers, then make sure you have already covered the topics for creating the app services, containers, container images, and Docker files, so that you know the basics of implementing app services in the container. You would require a lot of AZ-203 questions and verified study materials to earn good passing scores. You can refer to the official curriculum and study guide to plan your module study and get the right information. After that, practice sample tests online. Once gained enough knowledge with this, then you should be able to step up into the next part of practicing hands-on, and this is the most crucial part in your learning journey. You can easily perform hands-on in Azure services since Azure provides a free tier option for newbies, and you get a $300 of credit in your Azure account once you have signed, which is valid for almost a year. Practicing hands-on will not only help you in cracking the exam, but it will also get you ready for your future job roles. In addition to that, check for the online trainings so that in case you have queries related to the subject, you can clear them right away. And experts' help is always recommended. Last but not least, join the forums related to Microsoft Azure and search for questions related to your subject and check out the questions asked by other people and go through the answers posted by the audience itself. It will always be helpful for you. So guys, the last suggestion from my end is that go for dumps only when you are thorough with the subject. You might be able to clear the exam and get certification from it, but believe me, you won't be job ready. As during the interview, without the practical approach, you won't be able to crack it or able to answer the questions by interviewer because you took the shortcut to get certified, right? So beware of the shortcuts. Do a thorough study with the proper implementations in Azure and rise up in your career path. Now you might be wondering how to take time for all this research and study, right? That is why we at Intellipaat are here for you. We understand that you as professionals face problems to take time out for skilling up from your personal life, right? That is why we have done all the hard work for you and have come up with a comprehensive course on AZ-203 certification exam. If you're interested, then you can go through the course details with the link provided in the description box. I hope this video was helpful for you. See you next time.